Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is the first Sunday of Lent. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. When he calls on me, I will answer him. I will deliver him and give him glory. I will grant him length of days.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, through the yearly observances of Holy Lent, that you may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. First reading, a reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people, saying, "The priest shall receive the basket from you and shall set it in front of the altar of the Lord, your God. Then you shall declare before the Lord, your God, 'My father was a wandering Aramean who went down to Egypt with a small household and lived there as an alien. But there he became a nation great, strong and numerous. When the Egyptians maltreated and oppressed us, imposing hard labor upon us, we cried to the Lord, the God of our fathers, and he heard our cry and saw our affliction, our toil and our oppression. He brought us out of Egypt with his strong hand and outstretched arm, with terrifying power, with signs and wonders. And bringing us into this country, he gave us this land flowing with milk and honey. Therefore, I have now brought you the first fruits of the products of the soil which you, O Lord, have given me. And having set them before the Lord, your God, you shall bow down in his presence." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble.
Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, say to the Lord, "My refuge and fortress, my God in whom I trust."
Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble.
No evil shall befall you, nor shall affliction come near your tent. For to his angels he has given command about you, that they guard you in all your ways.
Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble.
Upon their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon the asp and the viper. You shall trample down the lion and the dragon.
Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble.
Because he clings to me, I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he acknowledges my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in distress. I will deliver him and glorify him.
Be with me, Lord, when I am in trouble.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, what does Scripture say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. That is, the word of faith that we preach, for if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth and so is saved. For the Scripture says, "No one who believes in him will be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all, enriching all who call upon Him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Verse before the Gospel. Glory and praise to you, O Christ. One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Filled with the Holy Spirit, Jesus returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the desert for 40 days to be tempted by the devil. He ate nothing during those days, and when they were over, he was hungry. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become bread." Jesus answered him, "It is written, one does not live on bread alone." Then he took him up and showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a single instant. The devil said to him, "I shall give to you all this power and glory, for it has been handed over to me, and I will give it to you whomever I wish. All this will be yours if you worship me." Jesus said to him in reply, "It is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him alone shall you serve." Then he led him to Jerusalem, made him stand on the parapet of the temple, and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to guard you, and with their hands they will support you, lest you dash your foot against a stone." Jesus said to him in reply, "It is also said, you shall not put the Lord your God to the test." When the devil had finished every temptation, he departed from him for a time. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Itong unang linggo ng Kwaresma, no, maganda yung ating ebanghelyo, the three temptations of Christ, no. Sabi nga ng mga scholar, ito sinasalamin din niya yung the three disciplines of Lent, no. So maganda rin yun. But I'd like to invite you to reflect on three points, no. The importance of stories or narratives, no. And then number two is the resisting of temptation. Then number three is the end of the 40 days, no, of Christ shows us, also warns us about how the evil spirit works, no. So those three things sa ating pagninilayan. Una, yung competing stories. Kung mapapansin niyo, the devil had his own narrative, no, and the narrative was very self-centered. I will make you this, I will make you that, I will make you this. And then the Lord counters that narrative or that story with his own narrative, no, about how he depends on God and how God has ordered things, no. So here you see the importance of narratives, of stories, no. As many writers would say, as many, you know, sociologists would say, psychologists, etc., that we are somehow defined by the stories that we tell in our society. So I think it's very important that we revisit the narratives that we tell our children, our youth, no? And to realize that it is very, very important that we tell them the stories that would reflect our core values and the truths of our society. The importance of stories, no? And then the second point is the resisting of the temptation. So kung yung unang punto, nakita natin yung magkaibang kwento, no? Ibang daloy ng mga kwento. At pinapakita na ang Panginoon ay gumagamit ng kwento na in a way, no, nagbubunyag ng kasinungalingan ni Satanas, no. I think that is the importance of the counter narrative of Christ, no, that he was able to reveal the fake news, no, and then all the lies of Satan, which brings us to that point that is one way of resisting temptation, no? When we hold on to the core values, when we hold on to God himself, no. I think the important thing here is that if you notice, Jesus is able to turn the tide in terms of resisting temptations. Remember, this narrative of temptations of Jesus in the desert also reminds us that the beginning of the victory of Christ happens here. because nabaligtad niya yung pagkukulang at yung the falling into the temptation of the chosen people when they were wandering in the desert. Of course, even going back farther, it also, in a sense, begins to defeat the falling into temptation, the falling into sin of Adam. So you see here now that Christ is able to turn back already, no? The temptations, the failures of previous generations. And I think it is important for us to also realize that I guess we also owe it to the coming generations that we begin to resist the temptations that we face now. No? Then the third and final point is that, again, this comes from Ignatius. No? Kung sabi ni San Ignacio, ang masamang espiritu ay papasok yan at tayo ay aakitin niya pagka malapit na tayo na magtalaga ng sarili sa Diyos. When we are closer to doing God's will and doing God's mission for us, the evil spirit will work double time, as we saw in the gospel. Because remember, Christ is now beginning his ministry. And take a look at how the evil spirit work with the temptations. Number one, sabi ko nga, when we are closer to God, the God's work and us doing the mission, he will distract us, discourage us, make us doubt things. Talagang lilituhin niya tayo. And tapos yung pangalawa, makikita mo, dadaanin niya kung saan tayo mahina. Itong kwento ng Panginoon, gutom, after 40 days of fasting. So if you realize, the very first temptation was the weakness or vulnerability of the Lord. And yan din hanggang ngayon. That is still the strategy of the evil spirit. So today, I think we can draw a lot of very, very personal applications of this narrative of the temptation of in the desert, and also ask the Lord to grant us the graces, no, to be able to identify the workings and the movement of the evil spirit, and for us to be able to overcome them in the same way that the Lord overcame the temptations. Hilingin natin to, na mabisto natin ang galaw ng masamang espiritu at bigyan tayo ng biyaya at ng gabay na manaig ang kabutihan at ma-resist natin ang mga temptation. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Heavenly Father, renew us in your covenant of mercy that leads us to everlasting life. With humble hearts we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. May the church leaders find strength in the Christ in the desert whenever they are tempted to live a life against the gospel. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the civil leaders be empowered by your love, O Lord, so that they may use material and spiritual gifts for common good, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we go through this pandemic, may we courageously witness to Jesus Christ through faith-inspired works of peace, justice, love, and compassion, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us again remember all the intentions, commended our prayers at this Mass. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
At sabay-sabay natin ipanalangin ang panalangin para sa halalan. Manalangin tayo upang sa papalapit na pabansa at panlokal na halalan ay tunay na maghari ang kalooban ng Diyos na siyang gumagabay sa lahat ng bansa. Sama-sama natin idalangin, iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa pamimilit, pananakot, karahasan at terorismo.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa panloloko, pagsisinungaling at pagbaluktot sa katotohanan.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa panunuhol, kasakiban at sabwatan upang magkapandaya.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa kawalang muwang na panlilinlang at makitid na pananaw.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa pagbabanta, pananakot at lapastangang pananalita.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Manalangin tayo, pastol ng aming kaluluwa at tagapagligtas ng sanlibutan, ang politika ang iyong sakaloob sa amin, isang paanyaya upang maglingkod sa iba at lumago sa kabanalan. Gabayan mo ang politika ng aming bansa katulad ng paggabay mo sa amin. Nawa ang aming politika na pakikilahok para sa mga botante at kandidato ay magdulot ng kaluwalhatian sa iyong mahal na ngalan at matulungan din kaming yumabong sa kabutihan ngayon at magpa sa walang hanggan. Amen. Amen. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Give us the right dispositions, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By abstaining 40 long days from earthly food, he consecrated through his fast the pattern of our Lenten observance, and by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, we might pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people, your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to seek your protection against COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you to look upon us with love and by your healing hand dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santonino de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Renewed now with heavenly bread by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live every word which proceeds from your mouth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we would like to offer now a prayer for the situation in Ukraine and for the people of Ukraine. We fly to your patronage, O Virgin Mother of God. Despise not our prayers in our needs, but deliver us from all dangers, since you alone are pure and blessed. O most glorious ever Virgin Mary, the Mother of Christ, our God, accept our prayers and present them to your Son, our God, that for the sake of you who enlighten and save our souls. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us, sinners now and in the hour of our death.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us, especially the people of Ukraine, and pray for the conversion of Russia.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us, especially the people of Ukraine.
The Prince of Peace,
have mercy on us, especially the people of Ukraine, and touch the hearts of the Russian soldiers.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May bountiful blessing, O Lord, we pray, come down upon your people, that hope may grow in tribulation, virtue be strengthened in temptation, and eternal redemption be assured through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Paumanhin lang, ano kasi ho, yung staff ng Caritas Philippines ay nag-retreat, no? Nasa Tagaytay sila nag-retreat, and immediately after the telethon last Wednesday, nag-retreat sila. So, I'm going to read the total of last week, ano, prior to the telethon. So, ang total so far ng ating funds for Alay Kapwa is 47,561.62. So, ito ho yung as of the previous week. Ano ho? Remember, 1 year na tayo ho nag-aalay kapwa. Remember, we started Ash Wednesday also of Lent last year. So, thank you very much. And again, we're looking forward to having more programs for the poor and yung mga marginalized sectors ng ating lipunan. Ano ho? So, thank you very much for all your support. And we'll report to you because we started a telethon to raise 400 million during this Lenten season up to Easter, para dun sa mga nasalantan ng Typhoon Odette, no? So I believe we did very well in the telethon, which we will report to you next Sunday. At saka, please do watch after this Journeys of Hope. Our guest is Edson Guido, the head of the data analytics unit of ABS-CBN News. And napaka-interesting kwento yung journey niya of how his science became a form of service. So marami pong salamat. Have a good Sunday. Have a prayerful Sunday, especially for this first Sunday of Lent. Thank you.
Ang Caritas Philippines po ay nagpaabot na ng tulong sa 11 dioceses at mahigit 70,000 families sa pamamagitan ng inyong mga tulong at donasyon. Sa kasalukuyan, kailangan pa po ng ating mga kababayan, tubig, kabuhayan, pabahay, at higit sa lahat, pagkain. Ipagpatuloy po natin ang ating pagtutulungan, pagmamalasakit, at pag-aalay kapwa.